Hey, what's up, everyone? This is Andrew. Welcome back. As you may have noticed, I've taken a little bit of a break. In that time, I got married, was on my honeymoon, had some other personal things going on. So I took a little bit of a hiatus from making the VV and Ecomi content, but now I'm officially back. As you can see, I'm in my new office slash studio. So I'm really excited to be back talking about this project going into 2022. Now, if you follow me, you probably follow some of the bigger VV content creators that have kept you up to date on all the exciting things that have happened this year, and especially at the beginning of this year with a lot of the blue chip, grail pieces, and pretty much everything across the board at the beginning of this year really start to get notice and the prices of those things really starting to shoot up. So it's been really cool. It's been really exciting to see, especially for people who've been around as long as I have and others since the beginning of last year, to finally see some of these collectibles come to fruition. And I believe it's still just the start of a really exciting year. So let's jump into some of the details. And I want to kick off my first video of this year talking about the golden moments. Now, I know people have talked about the golden moments inside and out, how historic it was, a lot of that stuff. But the one thing I want to bring up is one specific collectible on what I think could, and possibly, in my opinion, be one of the biggest sleepers of the group. Now, just to be 100% clear, I don't think you can go wrong with any of the golden moments. You know, the first ever Pixar, the first ever Star Wars. I mean, you name it, there's so much to choose from in those golden moments, and I think there's a lot of room for growth across the board there. But I want to bring up some of the details that you may not know about with this specific NFT, and also I've seen some details circulating about this one specifically, and actually I'm kind of asking for clarification on this as well, because I think it could be a real big catalyst for this one, especially in the long term. So before we jump into it, if you're a subscriber to this channel, thank you for hanging around, especially when I've been taking my break. And if you are new and you like this content by the end of it, I'm going to be posting much more consistently now. So hit that subscribe button, throw a thumbs up in there, comment down below, and let's jump into this. So as we know, we have the first ever Star Wars NFTs with this. We have the first ever Pixar NFTs with the Wall-E, the pizza truck. We also have Elsa and the Fantasia hat, which have really been going bonkers in terms of price. But that's not the one that I specifically want to talk about. The one I do want to talk about is the first ever drop for the Golden Moments, and that's the Simpsons drop here. And out of the two, we have the Homer and Bart, and then we also have the skateboard. The one I want to talk about is the Homer and Bart. Now, after this whole Golden Moment series was dropped, there were some questions. Which one was the actual first Disney NFT? Because we have some of the Disney animation. We also have, you know, things that are Disney owned, like Marvel. So what counts as the actual first NFT? And Vivi cleared it up with this tweet here. So they said, it depends on how you define it. We have the first Disney owned being the Spider-Man. We have the first Disney license drop being the Homer and Bart, and then the first Walt Disney animation being the Elsa. So once again, with any three of those, you can't go wrong. These are the first of for their own category. But just from what I've seen in terms of price wise, I see the Homer and Bart really kind of lacking behind. And it makes me really think, because there's so much to do with this NFT collectible and everything that it has entailed behind it. Number one, if we want to get technical here, in the metadata, on the description of the collectible, this will say Disney license, and it was the first one that was dropped as a Disney license drop. And that, no matter how history unfolds going forward, that's always going to be the first Disney license NFT that was dropped on the blockchain. So that alone, I think, is a really big deal. But on top of that, we have the first ever Simpsons NFT. We also have the first appearance of Homer and the first appearance of Bart, all wrapped up into one of these. Now, if you actually turn the collectible over and you can see on the bottom of the stand that it's on, it is actually the only Golden Moments that is signed by this man here, Matt Groening. And if you don't know who he is an American artist, cartoonist, writer, producer, and animator. And if we go into The Simpsons here, it says that he is the creator of The Simpsons and is the original artist for The Simpsons. And that's a huge deal. Yeah, all the golden moments, he's the only one who has a signature at the bottom of the Homer and Bart statue. So all those details alone is just big deal. But I recently saw a tweet from Sam Ellis that really brought some news to light that I think is something we really need some clarification on. Now, his tweet mentioned, so the recent news has surfaced that the design of the first Disney company NFT was done by the legendary Todd McFarlane. I'm convinced this is the most slept on golden moment. Will we see this become the Todd 2.0? So now if you see them side by side, the Todd McFarlane design of this is pretty much a spitting image of what VV dropped there. Now, just as a reminder, if you don't know who Todd McFarlane is, he is the designer of this Batman here, Batman number 100 of the Batman Black and White Series 1. And this was a physical statue. All the Batman Black and White from 1 to 100 was a physical statue series. But they decided, Vivi and David Yu, Dan Carruthers, decided this was the very first NFT for DC, the first Batman NFT, and the first ever NFT dropped on the Vivi app. So the fact that Todd McFarlane is that, and if you've been around for a while, you know that this one is nicknamed the Todd for Todd McFarlane. So his name is synonymous with the first ever NFT on Vivi. And is really going to go down in history as one of the top artists just because of that. So the fact that he now, if you go to his company's website here of his toys, you can see that this is the statue that they sell on their website. And this was, according to, you know, the news going around, that this was the statue of his design of this here. So as you can see, they have a whole Simpsons line here. And this is the Todd McFarlane line of the Homer choking Bart. So once again, I can't confirm this 100% if this is the statue that they went on, and I don't know why he wasn't given credit for this design within the description. So that's what I'm asking for clarification on, and I want to bring that out to you guys as well, just so you know that this is a possibility as well. But to sum everything up, this was the first Disney licensed NFT, and that's according to Vivi here in this tweet. It is the first Simpsons NFT. It is also the first appearance of Homer, the first appearance of Bart, all in one statue here. It's the only one with the original creator of The Simpsons, Matt Groening, signed at the bottom. And potentially this is the Todd McFarlane designed version of the Homer and Bart statue all wrapped up into one. So once again, do your own research on this. Like I said, you can't go wrong with any of the golden moments. You know, just the fact that you even know about these collectibles at this time when they're still within reach is amazing. And if you're looking to add something to your collection, I just want to bring this up to you because if this is like the Todd 2.0, the Todd McFarlane Batman, it was kind of a slow creeper. It really didn't do anything most of the year. And then it basically 5 to 10X'd in a month. And we know that Todd is going to go down in history as the first ever collectible on Vivi. But now with this one, it could be the Todd 2.0 with all those factors combined for the golden moments. So let me know your thoughts. I thought this was really interesting. I do think that this could be a sleeper, especially in the long run. And the fact that it's kind of sitting in the middle of the pack right now, even though it was the very first ever Disney licensed NFT, I think that's interesting. But me personally, full disclosure, I hold one of these and I plan on holding these for the long term. So let me know your thoughts, comment down below, and I'll see you on the next one.